What's up, YouTube? ODST Journal back again with Hazard Construction, or HazardCon for short. Now, as you guys know, when we left off, we were doing this house extension here. Now, all of good bits been done because I had to cut about half the video due to some audio issues, and I might have to do the same thing here just because I haven't managed to actually track the problem, what's causing it. So just to catch you guys up on what's been done, we've delivered our supplies and we had to pour cement here. So this little area here, we've poured cement down and that's where this concrete's come from. The brick here was laid when we laid down our supplies. We've got our concrete pump and our cement mixer here. And yeah, so right now our current goal is to go pick up some more supplies. We got to get bricks, concrete bags, and insulation material. So we are going to, of course, want to go and get in our truck here again. And we're going to go ahead and just skip over to the material dealer. I do apologize, guys, just for the fact that this was a large part of the last video, too. And I was hoping to have some more variety included, and that didn't quite happen as I planned. You know, what are you going to do, though? Like I said, I am having audio issues that was a concern at the start of the video. Unfortunately, it reared its head and, you know, didn't have much choice but to cut the video at that point. Because as much as you guys may or may not want to have seen the footage, the last thing you guys wanted was a hurricane every time I took a small breath out of my nose. And that is still a concern here. I can see that my audio levels are a little bit low, but my mic's not right in front of my eye like it is last time I was recording the video. So hopefully this turns out okay, and the audio quality is half decent. If not, at the very least, you know, loud enough that you guys can hear it reasonably. Forgot to drop that down, so let's get back in here and finish that now. And yeah, it's kind of a problematic issue. I'm just got a late Christmas present from a aunt of mine, and I think I might look into getting a Blue Yeti mic. I had originally tried raising funds for that. I was gonna kind of blow it off once I got this, just because the audio quality of this one, the recordings were working out, is really good. I mean, it was quite a bit better than my other microphone, but you know, the pop filter is built into this one. And it's a very sensitive microphone, which in some ways is good, in other ways it's not so great. In fact, I think I'd almost rather have a non-sensitive microphone. But obviously, I would like you guys to hear what I say. I'd like you guys to hear it somewhat clearly. Unfortunately, I have a bad time pronouncing certain letters, so like T's and stuff come across kind of quietly. That sounds kind of goofy the way I say them. Oh, that's not good. There we go, now it's fastened. I was trying to get it to fasten, didn't want to there. Yeah, so this is going to be kind of a pain in the butt for me just to kind of keep half an eye on my recording at the same time trying to drive around a forklift. Because I'm so paranoid I don't have to, like, cut this video. I want 4 days without a video, which isn't too bad, I guess, compared to some people. A lot of people go like a week or two without doing like videos, or sometimes longer, and those are bigger channels than mine. But with my channel, I try to have consistent content, and I think that with a Let's Play channel, that's lots more important than, say, something like Epic Rap Battles of History or the Alternate History Hub, where basically you've got videos you're putting out every, you know, week or every 2 weeks, 3 weeks, whatever it is. You know, because the content's slightly more original, whereas you guys get content that you could find other places for me, you know, and you're basically just coming here for something, I don't know. I can't guess why half of you are coming here. A couple of our friends who would come here out of pity. Once in a great, great, great blue moon, my girlfriend will throw me a pity like here on YouTube. But my channel bores the heck out of her, so I don't know. Let's spin this around here and kill anybody in the way because I'm an awful forklift driver. just gonna be driving around and like impale the dealer or something because I'm not paying attention to where I'm driving. Actually, this is going a lot better than the last time. We did have that one we almost dropped here, but I think last time we were loading this truck up with these, we lost almost every single thing we loaded on here just because I was going a little too quick when I was picking stuff up. Other game news though, I upgraded in Star Citizen. I got a new ship. I got the Freelancer, which, because it's horribly bugged right now, they're loaning me the Constellation. It's still kind of unstable though. I had a bunch of crashes, but I know I've played the game for like hours on end. Constellation is actually one. See right there, I'm saying Constellation. That's Constellation with a T. Like I said, I'm really bad at pronunciating that stuff. But yeah, anyways, I got one of those on loan, and it's pretty fantastic, actually, like having my own, and just like I don't have to like share it with anybody if I don't want to, which defeats the purpose of the ship, obviously. Okay, I have to drive to the site then. Yeah, it's dirt you can teleport, I guess, but with legitimate cargo you can't. So we're gonna just head on out here and get going. But the other thing was pretty amazing. I haven't really had a whole lot of chance to fly. It's actually like 3 a.m. my time right now. I could have made that light. Or not, I don't know. So yeah, this is a real late recording session. I got off at about 12:30 my time. So I've been off of work for about 3 hours now. A little bit less. But I do work at noon tomorrow, so after I record this video, I have to basically leave it sit, get ready to go to bed here. So unfortunately, I don't know how long this video will be. Seems kind of silly to build like a single house into this, like into three video parts. But it does actually take a good amount of time if you're actually trying to like legitimately drive everywhere and do everything properly, especially when you're by yourself, which is why I want to get into the multiplayer aspect of it. Unfortunately, like I said, I only got a couple friends in my playlist who actually play this game. I might be able to convince another friend or two to get it, but I think that'll make it a lot more enjoyable as working with other people. At least just for my own personal sake, I know that's what I was kind of looking for, is for the multiplayer aspect of it. And that's not to say the single player isn't fun. I mean, obviously it's doing the same thing. It's just doing this in a group. And that's why I need a pop filter, because I'm saying P words. Go. Go faster. It's gonna be a red light by the time I cross this intersection. Well, thankfully we're not too far from the site now. I can already see it. Of course, again, we're gonna hit another red light too, so you know, there's that. No, F you guy. I don't appreciate that tone your license plate's taking with me. All right, let's get rolling again. I got my other vehicles there. Oh, that's gonna be an issue. I'm gonna have to move those. Okay, so we're gonna actually just park right here for right now. And we're going to move our cement mixer. Actually, do I have any more cement I wanna be needing to mix? We're on stage 5. Paramount. So we'll need it still. So we're going to actually just move these guys over this way. This seems like an awful place to have a house. You just, like, it's all massive houses except for that like those ones across the street, but this is just like a normal house. They got a big apartment complex right next to them, and then some sort of, I don't know, is that a grocery store? I can't really tell. I'm kind of cheating here. I should be doing that in first person, but can't be bothered right now. We do have to set these supplies up on the roof, so that's gonna be a little bit more of a interesting than just kind of dropping them on the ground because we'll actually have to put something higher, I guess. It's doing the same thing we already did, but doing it differently. So, as you guys can tell, my AI set that dirt up a lot better than I did. Oh yeah, I don't know. You guys might not have seen that part because I can't remember where I actually cut the video, but we had to fill in that hole too. And yeah, I filled it and I got like halfway done using both loads. So I just let the AI do it without any fee, and it was a lot better. Guess it was because the dirt was already there, it just needed to be spread out properly by somebody who knows what they're doing, which thankfully is the computer. It's probably why he gets done with his job so much faster than I do. There we go. I guess that was fully extended. I haven't controlled this crane in like a whole day and a half, and I've like totally forgotten how to use it. Don't fall. What is this? Let's get this stuff farther away first, and then we'll work our way back in. We'll go with the cement next, just so we don't have it fall off on us. It looks like this will be another story, and we'll probably go into the side of the house where you see those stairs going up. Pretty nice house, but it's kind of a weird layout for it. Like, you have to go into the side part of the house to, like, access the second story. And like I said, this whole, like, side of the house is, like, the expansion, it looks like. So, who designs a house like this where it's just, like, half a house? Or maybe they were, like, building the whole house, but the other contractor sucks, so they fired him and hired us. I don't know. I don't know how they could be worse than me. I mean, look at me. I'm just, like, cramming these bricks into each other. There's gonna be a bunch of like chips in the bricks on their house, damaging the concrete for the foundations. That's another thing too, is who builds like a regular household with like concrete stairs? I mean, concrete floors, stairs, everything. It is, yeah, sure, it's a brick house, brick siding, and stuff like that, but that just seems unusual to me. Foundation, yeah, I get that. And we just gotta get this last one and we're set to go. And we've surpassed 1,060 subscribers, which is pretty awesome. We did lose a person or two, which is a shame. That always sucks. Because even though I don't really know who it is right offhand, that's because as far as I know, I have no way of no checking that. It always just kind of sucks to know. Somebody kind of got sick of me and just decided that they didn't want to watch what I had to produce anymore. Okay, so there's the second story. It looks like we'll have one more story to build after this. I thought that might be both of them, but I guess not. But first things first, I'm going to have to awkwardly pour some concrete down here. Let's try this again here. There we go. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that button. Oh, because I switched modes, that's why. Alright, get that brought back in. And I don't know if there's room for me to drive around. I think those other trucks will be in the way, so we're just gonna back up. Hopefully I don't hit too much. See, I wish I could look further back behind me to see what's actually going on. Another handy thing for having a person is they can check your blind spots for you. Yeah, they're not gonna like me, but whatever. I've got 78% concrete in here, so we're gonna just try to pour what I've got left in here, and we'll see how it works out. Alright, let's deploy. Let's deploy our outriggers. Let's deploy the outriggers here, get set up, get the boom going here. So there's our deployed. I don't know if I really need to extend every arm on this, but it feels like that's the only way to efficiently control it. So if you guys look, to get up here, I have to like extend this way out over, and then that drops down. So I have to pretty much extend it to almost full length to efficiently do this. And we're just gonna kind of go back here. I don't know if we're gonna have enough in here. It's kind of awkward here. I'm setting this up. There we go. That's the way I need to push this. Yeah, it's not gonna be enough. That is really complex. Yeah, I don't think I really just appreciated how complex this was until just now. Okay, so that is empty, so we are going to need the cement mixer. Luckily, we still have it here. And this will make this a lot easier. I did forget to open the lid on that, and that would have been a smart thing for me to do before I got out of it. I mean, look how much higher than the building this is. I mean, that's pretty ridiculous. I feel like I'm doing this inefficiently, but what do I know? Alright, that's open. I just need to get around here. We're going to, of course, change the direction that funnel is pointing. We just want that looking straight back if possible. And we're going to change the direction of the barrel here so it starts pouring some concrete in. Maybe should have waited just a tad bit. So let's see here. I need to get back. So let's retract this. See, this is what I'm talking about here. Well, let's stop this here. Oh, maybe. Maybe. Okay, that's stopped. We need to get back in here. Let's do that. That works. Like carpet bomb the stuff we need to work on. Come on, baby. I don't know how I'm gonna do this, guys. I feel like I need to move the truck, or I should park the truck further away. That probably would have been my best bet, truly. I think I just parked it too dang close. Can I just pour it from there, from that angle? No. Let's see if I do. This, maybe? I don't know. We're gonna reset this. And we're gonna move the truck. So future lesson, guys, if you're doing this, don't park close to the building. And let's redeploy here, if I can. This doesn't seem safe. But what do I know? I'm not a construction worker. Okay. Extend this again. Carpet bombing. So I've got to be getting pretty close to done on this. It looks like, yeah, I am. So we're going to pour along here. Pump and turn. Wow, I finished 10. You wouldn't think so by the way I did that. All right, so we gotta get a bunch more bricks and stuff like that, guys. Also, I should think about purchasing a new vehicle. I don't really know what they want me to get. Thinking I should get a better crane. I'd imagine that would be the best thing. Either that or something that's better at digging holes. I haven't really felt the urge or need to get any anything else really different than what I have right now, at least not yet. I'm sure the need and the urge will come then, but we'll see. All right, so we gotta make another trip here to the material dealer, and then we've got more stuff to do on this side. That's hard to believe. Oh wait, no, that is the last stage for us. Okay, so let's go get this stuff, get it unloaded, and we're set to go. Well, these people waited patiently. And I mean, you guys can see this is still a long video, even with us doing the fast travel. So I'm kind of glad that I ignored the thing I said in the last video near the start, which is I'm probably just gonna drive everywhere unless you guys say so. I mean, obviously there's that cost of money, but it's necessary, I think. Well, we don't just need to go to the material dealer, do we? We need to get sawmill too. Okay. I think that's bigger stuff over at the sawmill as well, or at least some of it is. All right, spin around here and plop this down. Oh gosh, no. It's perfect. Oh gosh. Why is there so many petals? How's the line from Red vs. Blue go? There's six petals in only four directions. All right, get over here. Get this guy on the top. I think that locked into place, did it? As I whip around the corner like insanely fast, I don't think that locked. It had to have, I guess. It says it unfastened. All right, line this up and get it. All right, that's fastened. Let's swing around the other side here. Can't see where I'm going. So, I don't know if I should just go and unload this first or if I should go to the sawmill and get everything at once. I guess let me look at the map and see where it is because I know from here the sawmill is pretty much almost, I think it's just like almost straight north. And I think if I go to the site, it's actually not too far out of the way of the site if I go to the site first and drop these off. I don't know if it would be easier or not to do that because at least one of those will be needs to be loaded by crane. And I'll probably just end up doing all of it by crane. As I stutter my way through that sentence. That's attached, right? I think that'll fix that. See, it's laid perfectly. See, I told you to accept it. Rental vehicles. Let's hop in, let's check our map. That's not our map. So that's the construction site, and then the sawmill's up there. So yeah, that's actually right on the way. So let's go, we'll unload this stuff. And, yeah, I mean, I don't know. Well, that's going to be the easiest way, I think. It's going to be a little tiny bit more time consuming just because we're making the extra stop instead of going straight through. But it's going to be considerably safer for the cargo we're carrying. What is this guy doing? He's like out in the middle of the intersection on a red. Just hanging out. So I told you, every once in a while you'll get that, like, AI kind of just kind of going, what are you doing? Like, what are your thoughts there? Thankfully, we're at, like, the half an hour mark. Yeah, we're actually past the half an hour mark for me. And, you know, we haven't really had any major issues with the mic yet. Fingers crossed, you know. But I'm okay with that. And I don't know if it's an issue of where I'm just placing my mic in just, like, just the very, very most incorrect position. But while I was doing it, I was having issues where basically anytime I'd breathe, like, no matter where I hit the mic, it was just like a hurricane and, like, the pop filter wasn't working or something. I think that's what it came down to. It's kind of weird, though, because obviously I record with OBS, or at least I'm assuming it's obvious to you guys if you've watched me stream. Yeah, and it's just, I test out the noise gate filter on that, and you would hear my breathing, but when I would try to speak, my speech would get cut off by the noise gate. Can't see the light. Oh, cool. It's almost green. There we are. Gosh, I can't help it. Like, every time I'm playing this, you know, just driving down a stretch of road here late at night, even a European-style truck like this, just can't help but think, eastbound down, we're gonna keep on trucking. Yeah, just that whole song is just stuck in my head, and it's like, so much of it too. Where do I need to drop this? Probably, yeah, up there. Okay, I think I can squeeze through here. I wasn't quite able to, at least not. Well, I don't know if I hit. No, I just hit that mound of dirt. I'm okay. Made it through all right. I won't need this anymore, so we're gonna just take the bets back to the home base in the city. And same with this guy, so we're gonna get him out of our way. And this one we shouldn't need either. Let's clear all these excess vehicles out of here. Now you, we will still need. All right, just walked right through the outrigger. That was fantastic. In other news that a lot of you might not be able to relate to, the original Blue Power Ranger turned 47 And that makes me feel so much older by extension, you know, because even though I was a lot younger than them, I was watching the show. That's what I needed to do. Even while I was, you know, a lot younger than them while I was watching the show, just the fact that they've gotten that much older makes me feel that much older by extension. It's like, man, they're just barely like a decade younger than my dad. I get these bricks here. I should actually just go for these other parts since they're a little bit easier position to move without knocking stuff over. Oop. Now see, here's another problem I have with this house. It's gotta be like a duplex or something because that's totally walled off. It doesn't make any sense how that's constructed. Like there's a wall that's dividing the freaking attic. Nobody designs houses like this anymore. Nobody ever designed houses like this. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. I'm making it worse. Let's see here. Pull that up. Pull this down. That works. I don't know where I was going with that. Feel like I've spent more money than I've made on this contract with all the cost of supplies and everything. I've also, like I said, just for the sake of this video, I haven't been using my second worker. Otherwise, I would have been stopping every like 10 seconds to put him on a new contract. Just because that's a really efficient way to make money. I'm actually losing out on a lot of money in this video just because I am doing it that way. So I'm still paying for the foreman and the worker, even though I'm not really using the foreman or the worker. Okay, we're gonna do this. We're gonna cheat a little bit. Retract the outriggers. And then we're gonna head up to Sawmill. That was awful close. All right. Now there's gonna be heavy traffic. Yeah, going back to Star Citizen, maybe I shouldn't talk about one game while playing another. yeah, I am kind of disappointed I don't get to use my Freelancer. I mean, the Constellation's a lot bigger of a ship, it's a lot higher tech, and it's a lot cooler, but man, oh man, that Freelancer, just something about it kind of reminds me of Serenity. Or Firefly. Depending on what you actually call the ship. Because I know people actually call the ship both. I think the ship's the Firefly class, and then the ship's name is Serenity, if I remember correctly. I know they mentioned the ship class name in one episode where he's like dying on the ship and he's thinking back to when he bought it. All right, we get to open up on this road in speed, but yeah, the Freelancer's a lot smaller of a ship, the crew's in a lot tighter quarters, and it just feels like everybody's banded together a little bit more so, like the bonds of the ship make the, being so small together just makes the bonds of the crew, I should say, a lot tighter. And oh, that didn't work out. That was sort of awesome, though. Yeah. Gosh, that should be a thing. Drifting massive trucks like that. Okay, so we've got two of those and one square beam. Why is it always two of those and one square beam? It isn't like there anything else I ever need to buy from this place. Because the other stuff there just for looks. Actually, if I do this, back up, and go at this from this side, I minimize the work I need to do. Still need to put the outriggers out, though. And up. See, because now instead of having to swivel this thing around the other side of the truck, all I gotta do is pretty much extend it out like so, and we're ready to go. And the beautiful part about using this crane to load stuff, even though I think it's a little bit more work, I don't know if that's actually accurate or not, is that all we gotta do is that. Swing this back around and we're set. Well, we're not set because we still gotta go get the rest of that. Switch. Oh, that's what it was. Okay. Now we can go down. Oh, come on. Those are retracted. Okay. Outriggers are out. We're going up right about now, and crane is set to go. Oh shit. I mean, oh darn. I put it backwards. Shoot. Okay. It's fine. I screwed up there. Got the side backwards. Even though I just got finished doing that, I screwed up. Oh, it's now 4 a.m., so got 8 hours until my shift starts. And I've got it. Okay. Now, if only I could just, keep it like this and just drive there. How fantastic would that be to have this just, hanging in front of the windshield, swinging back and forth? Okay, let's get heading out here. We're gonna retract the outriggers if we, of course, switch back into the correct mode. Oh, you know, I did forget one minor detail. Just attach that. Make sure our cargo is secure. Kind of wish I had selected a different character. Now I want somebody with a reflective vest. Oh, I accidentally bumped my mic. Just kind of terrified there for a second. I was like, oh man, did I knock it into the wrong position? Is everybody gonna all of a sudden start having a wind tunnel? I have to cut the very end of this mission. Where is all this traffic coming from? Like, every time I'm leaving this place, there's just like three cars that decide to come through. And they all go real slow around the corner in the train tracks there. Mean, I get it, it's a sharp corner guy, but come on. And I don't even understand why he stopped there. Another thing I noticed, there's never any trains in this town. That's unusual. Oh my God, this is the Truman Show. Oh my God. Drift Tokyo. Where is he coming from? That was actually pretty fantastic. I want to do that again. Go drifting this truck around. It didn't work. Didn't drift that time. Didn't have enough speed built up. How terrified do you think this guy was as he hears that screeching of a giant truck behind him? It's okay, guys. We're almost there. The only thing they had to sacrifice for this massive and yet odd expansion on their house was their yard. And, you know, a very, very large bill, but that's okay. Okay. Set the crane up, get ready to go here. Gotta love good old American Dad. All right, and gotta set these a little bit further in just so we have room for the big one here. Actually, no, I can just set that up. I don't know. I was gonna say I could set that up long ways, but I don't know if my crane would extend that far to get that up there. So let's instead put this up in that spot that I'm looking at. So we'll set that there, and we just need one last one. We're all set, guys. Get to see the fruits of our labor here, hopefully. I mean, as far as duplexes go, I feel like this is probably pretty roomy. Okay, that was unusual. clear the construction area. So as soon as we get that out far enough, it should actually just build everything. Or not, it might actually want us to clear out. There we go, now we can swing this the rest of the way. And fold it over. And get rid of the outriggers here. We'll also flow up. Yeah, we're gonna flow up. I don't know what that means. So we got 139,000 for that. It's not too bad. Interesting design of the house. Like I said, it's kind of unusual. It actually, I just realized the house is like two different colors. It looks really tacky. But no, that's a pretty nice house though. All right, guys. Well, that was a good build. Let's go inspect it here. I don't think we'll be able to go around inside anymore, but we'll go enjoy the fruits of our labor. Got really, really cheap basketball hoop. I can't get it. This is all blocked off to me now. I can't get down here anymore. Apparently, now that I'm done with the job, they don't want to deal with a plebe like me. Can I play in the sandbox even? No, I can't even go on the property at all. Oh wait, there we go. It's fine. I know why I'm not wanted. Anyways, guys, make sure to like, subscribe, share the video. I'm sorry it took so long, but like I said, even a smaller build like this, well, this one's pretty big for a standard build so far for me, but I appreciate you guys sticking around this long if you have. Make sure to like, subscribe, share the video like always, guys. It is very much appreciated. It helps me out on the channel a lot. I know it's a minor thing to do, and it takes no amount of time. I know how you guys feel fucking ask this all the time, but I do appreciate it. All right, guys, take it easy.